Hello everyone, welcome to this presentation on addressing the sanitation challenge of coastal villages. This presentation is based on our experience for the past 14 years in Kameshwaram, which is a coastal village in South India. I would like to kickstart this presentation by bringing your attention to the Clean India mission. So this is a mission which was introduced by the government of India a few years ago, and we have come a long way with that. And it has three major objectives, which is availability, which means toilets for all, and then acceptability, which indicates that behavior change should come along with the toilets, and then safe technology, which means that technology, having technology that does not affect the natural resources. We'll just get to the problem on what it is. Okay, let us have a look at what are the problems in developing countries with large coastal areas, India included. So there are two main problems. The first one is, of course, pit littering, and second one is rushing towards ODF. Let's have a look at both of these things in detail. Let's start with pit littering.
Shanmugan, you can go slowly because...
Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah, thanks for that, ma'am. Right. Okay, so let's start with pit littering. So coastal areas actually have high water table. So why is pit littering not suited here? It's very simple, groundwater contamination. It simply doesn't work there. So, just a second. Yes. Okay. Let's have a look at the vicious impact cycle of pit latrines. So let's start with poor health here. Poor health is due to lack of sanitation. And then to tackle that, what do? We build low-cost pit latrines, and which in turn lead to water contamination, which again leads to poor health, and then the cycle continues. So this is exactly what we are trying to break here. So you may ask, why are pit latrines still being built and used in the coastal region in spite of these things? Two very simple factors. The first one is low cost, of course. And the second one is it's built largely by government and large international as well as national public agencies. So it is widely used by the people until it becomes unusable, and then people go back to their old ways. This is the reason. Let's now have a look at the other problem. We are in a rush to build more number of toilets. Lots of developing countries in particular are trying to become ODF in a very short span of time. So millions of toilets are being built without going through proper research of geography and other factors. So we see that there are four major parameters for effective construction and use of toilets: quantity, time, quality, and behavioral change. When we try to force in quantity and time into the equation, your quality and behavior change goes for a toss. So that's exactly what we mean by trying to rush into things with more quantity and with less number of time actually leads to lesser quantity and behavioral change. So what are the results of rushing? The first one obviously is non-existent or partially constructed toilets, which will have lack of running water inside the toilets. And then we have defective constructed toilets, which are unusable and of course non-maintenance. So where are these things actually leading us to? Two things. First thing is underutilization of toilets. And another one is suboptimal health outcome, which is not getting the full benefits of toilets that it is intended to. We'll come to behavioral change, especially in coastal areas with large beaches, which practically serve as public toilets. It's very difficult to bring behavioral change here. This is a problem with the gentlemen, especially in the village, because they use the time in the morning to relieve themselves and socialize with their friends. So it's a major, major problem here. So we suggest EcoSan as an ideal technology for coastal villages. We will see why in the following slides. Let me start with the circular design of EcoSan here. We eat and poop. EcoSan being a dry toilet, the urine and feces are separated. And the feces is dried separately, and then the feces is changed to compost. And this compost can actually be used for growing trees, which give us fruits and vegetables. And the cycle continues, right? Okay, let's get to understanding EcoSan even better. The EcoSan toilet has actually three holes, one for wash water, one for the feces, and one for urine. So these three are collected separately and they are processed. So the feces is composed is actually collected in a chamber, which is underneath and above the ground level, so that it doesn't contaminate the groundwater. And then all you have to do is throw in a handful of ash after you shit, and then it's done. It turns into compost itself in, say, 6 to 9 months. Let's understand the design of EcoSan toilets a little bit more. The picture on your left is a side view of an EcoSan. It has a vent pipe for obvious reason. It has a detachable door at the back. This is where this is the passage via which you will get the compost after X number of months. And you can see two pipes over there. One pipe is for the urine, which is actually connected to an earthen pot, which actually collects this urine, dilutes it, and then lets it into the ground. And we have another one for wash water, where the feces is actually filtered out and then let it seep into the ground. And the photo on your right is a compost obtained from one of the toilets. How is EcoSan creating value in multiple ways? First of all, is very high quality compost, and the most important thing of all is no contamination, because this is what it's actually makes it stand out from pit latrines, and then no desludging is required. So because of this, there are no third parties or any other people involved. So it makes it makes the maintenance easier, and it also obviously helps in improving the health to a great extent. I would like to share some instances of positive impact of EcoSan in Kameshwaram. A study in 2019 showed us that for every additional 100 households having EcoSan toilets, at least 109.5 incidents of excreta related diseases can be avoided. So these are diseases like typhoid, cholera, cough, cold, and diarrheal related diseases. So this is what I mean by improved health. This is actually a very interesting story. Kameshwaram has both fishermen as well as farmers, this village. The one on the right is Mr. Paramasivan, who's a fisherman. He is a very vocal advocate of EcoSan toilets in the village. We can see his papaya trees on the left. They bear the biggest fruits in the village. He uses the compost from his toilet to grow this one. This actually makes the farmers a little bit jealous. So that's an interesting one. This is an impact which is close to my heart, which is women's health. The photo on the left is a family. The lady over there had urinary tract infections, and she was unable to conceive. But on receiving the EcoSan toilets, her infections were reduced, and she was able to conceive a baby. The family was actually really, really happy with that, and they actually named the toilet as well as the child after a founder. It was a very touching story for us. And the photo on the right is of a girl who actually topped the high school examinations in the village, and she attributed that to having a toilet in the house when compared to her peers. All being said, what is the road ahead for us? We have come a very long way from where we were 14 years ago, but we are constantly exploring many things. We are able to make a lot of design improvements, but we are constantly looking for improvements. Even though we are able to build strong climate resilient toilets with which people even take shelter during cyclones and things like that, we are looking to cut down the cost to make it more sustainable. And the third one is we're trying to make it user friendly so that it can be enjoyed by elders, kids, and adults alike. On behalf of people of Kameshwaram and Finn, I would like to thank you for attending this session. Hope you found this useful. Thank you.